Following are the taxable incomes of Sri Ratan Chand for the previous year 2019-20. You have to take the heading like this. Write this one. Computation of gross total income for the assessment year 2020-21. Then you have to prepare three amount columns. Here particulars, ordinary resident, resident or ordinary resident, not ordinary resident, non-resident. Is it clear? Ordinary resident or resident, not ordinary resident, non-resident. Now let us see the problem. Income from salary accrued and received in India 20,000. This income is earned in India and received in India. Income from salary accrued and received in India means it is earned and received in India. India dalle earn agide, India dalle receive agide. So it is applicable to all the three. Income from salary accrued and received in India. Income from salary accrued and received in India. What is the amount? 20,000. 20,000, 20,000, 20,000. Is it clear? Second one, profit of a hotel business at Melbourne. Profit of a hotel business at Melbourne. It is a foreign income earned and received outside India. It is earned and received outside India. So it is applicable only for resident, ordinary resident. Profit of a hotel business at Melbourne. Profit of Melbourne hotel business. That is the amount 30,000, applicable only to ordinary resident because it is neither received nor earned in India. So it is applicable only to resident. Third one, dividend declared in Perth but received in India. It is foreign dividend. If it is a dividend of Indian company, then it is exempt from tax. It is not taxable. But it is a foreign dividend. It is earned in Perth but received in India. This income is received in India. So it is applicable to it is all the three. It is received in India. So third one, dividend earned in Perth, received in India. How much? What is the amount? 4,000. 4,000. 4,000. Is it clear? Next one. Income from transfer of a long-term capital asset in India. The assessee has earned some income by selling a long-term asset. By selling, transfer means sale. Selling a long-term asset, he has earned some income. That is the income earned and received in India. Earned and received in India. So it is applicable to? It is earned and received in India. So it is applicable to all the three. Income from a long-term transfer of long-term capital asset. Income from transfer of long-term capital asset. How much? 20,000. 20,000. 20,000. 20,000. Next one. Interest on debentures of a company at Manchester which was received in India. This income is earned in Manchester but it is received in India. So applicable to all the three. Interest on debentures. Interest on debentures of Manchester company received in India. Manchester company received in India. 6,000. You need not write the particulars in detail. If you write in it in short, it is enough. Next. Interest received from Sri Philip, a non-resident, on the loan provided to him for a business carried on in India. Business is carried on in India. Here Sri Philip is doing a business in India. To him, the assessee has provided some loan. The assessee has given some loan to Sri Philip. And Sri Philip is doing business in India. So Sri Philip has paid some interest to the assessee. Namma assessee Sri Philip ge loan kottidane yake India dalli business madodakke aa business maadi aa loan kottidakke Philip ivunige interest kottidane andre adu earned in India agutte hagagi murakku barutte interest received from Sri Philip. From Sri Philip. It is earned and received in India. How much? 5,000. 5,000. Next. Royalty received in Germany from Sri Kailash, a resident in India, for technical services provided for a business carried on in Germany. Royalty is received in Germany and it is also earned in Germany. It is not earned in India, not received in India. So it is applicable to ordinary resident only. Royalty earned and received in Germany. Royalty earned and received in Germany. How much? 20,000. Next. Fees from an Indian company carrying on business at London for technical services rendered at London, having been directly deposited by the company in his bank account in India. Fees is received from the Indian company. The Indian company is doing business in London. Fees is received for the technical services given to that company at London. Means the amount is earned in London, but it is received in India because the amount is directly deposited by the company in his bank account in India. London alli earn aadidruno adu elli payment agutte India da bank account ge direct agi pay madutte hagage adu received in India. So received in India agirodrinda yari barutte for all the three. Fees from Indian company received in India. Fees from Indian company received in India. How much? 30,000. For all the three. 30,000. Now find out the total. That is the gross total income. Gross total income. What is the total in the case of resident? Gross total income. Here it is 1,35,000. Here 85,000. For non-resident it is how much? 85,000.